Now today's topic is motion of a charge particle in an electric field. Topic number A, when charge particle at rest is placed in the uniform magnetic field. So this is the uniform field. I denote E with the electric field. If we place positive charge, then force is along right hand direction. If we place negative charge, then the force is along left hand direction. F is equals to QE, and here is also F is equals to QE. We know that F is equals to QE. By this formula, we know F is equals to MA, therefore A is equals to F upon M. Is equals to what, beta? Again A, we have to put the value of F from this. A is equals to F ki jagah kya rakha hum logon ne, QE N upon M. Since E is constant, this electric field is constant, therefore the acceleration is also constant. Whose acceleration? Acceleration of a charge particle or a charge. Now we need to find the velocity. Here capital V is the potential difference between A and B. This point is A and this point is B, and this S is the distance between these two points A and B. S, what is S? Separated difference. So by using Newton's equation, by using motion equation, V is equals to U plus AT. Here initial velocity is 0, therefore V is equals to 0. We have put acceleration from here, that was A is equals to Q E M into T. This T is here. If it is 0, therefore V is equals to Q E T upon M. This is the velocity of a charge. Now by using third equation, V square is equals to U square plus 2AS. Again U is 0, therefore V square is equals to 2, again A is equals to QA upon M. S is placed over there, therefore V is equals to root of 2 QES upon M. Now we already find acceleration, moment, velocity. Now we are going to find momentum of a charge. We know that momentum is represented by P. Having a formula, P is equals to ME, that is P is equals to M. We have put value of V from here, QET by M. M is cut by cutting by M, therefore P is equals to QET. This is the momentum of a charge. Now you are going to find kinetic energy of a charge in a uniform electric field. The kinetic energy, we know the formula, half mv square. It is half m. Again we have to put the value of v from here, from the air, q e by m. Therefore q square e square upon m square and t square. That is p, not t square. It is only e square. M square is cut by m square, therefore we have kinetic energy equals to half q square e square upon m. Is it okay? Now our next topic is when a charged particle enters with an initial velocity at right angle. Here the charged particle is enter in a linear motion, okay? But here the charge particle is enter perpendicularly. If the charge particle enters perpendicularly, then it describes as a parabolic path, okay? Now the next topic is electric potential energy. What is potential energy? Now we have to find potential energy of a two charges system. Second thing, potential energy is always change. What is potential energy of two charges? It is always change in the potential energy. That is delta U is equals to minus W. This is work done, negative of work done, either conservative force or negative of Coulomb force. For to understand this, we have to consider an example. Consider a system of two charges Q1 and Q2. This is your Q1, this is your Q2. The distance between Q1 and Q2 is represented by R1. If we move a charge A, Q2, from A to B and mark a two different position over there. Now the distance from Q1 to DR is R, from Q1 to B is R2. The electric force on Q2. Now you have to find the electric force, your electrostatic force on Q2. So we know the formula of Coulomb's law. F is equals to Q1 Q2 upon R square. That is, I have put value of K 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught over there. Therefore, F is equals to Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square. This is R cap. If we want to find out the total work done, the total work done on Q2 when it moves from here, B2, it is not from B to C, it is from A to B. Sorry, students. It is from A to B. Now, W is equals to R1, se lekar kahan tak jana hai? R2 tak, Q1, Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, R square, dr. W is equals to what? It is the formula of force and it is displacement. We know that work is equals to force into displacement. Now, W is equals to Q1, Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. By solving this, I'll find 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R2. Now, we need to find the change in potential energy, that is potential energy from R2 minus potential energy of R1. Again, U, that is potential energy, UR2 minus UR1 is equals to minus W, that is Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon R2 minus R1. You have to note this thing, that potential energy of two charges is assured to be zero. Only there is condition when, this is very important, when they have infinite separation. That means if the separation between the two charges is infinite, that means their potential energy is assured to be a zero. Now, potential energy when the separation is R, then instead of R1 and R2, we use UR is equals to UR minus U infinity. That is Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon R minus 1 upon infinity. If we neglecting this, then we will find Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R. Again, this is an important note. Electric potential energy is a scalar quantity. So, in the above formula, you can take Q1 and Q2 also in spite of small Q1 and Q2 because it remains constant. Now, electron volt, EV, what is it? It is the smallest practical unit of energy acquired by a particle. What is it? Smallest practical unit of energy acquired by a, by whom? Charged particle having one quantum of charge, that is one electron. When one electron, when accelerated by one volt, that is one electro volt. One electron means 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb, and volt means joule upon coulomb. This coulomb is cut by this coulomb, therefore we find 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 joule in the form of SI, or 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 12 erg in the form of CGS. Potential energy of a system of n charges. Here we find potential energy between the two charges. If we have more than two charges, for that we have to understand that in a n system of charges, potential energy is calculated for each pair, then all the energies so obtained are added. For example, each pair means Q1, Q2, Q2, Q3, Q4, Qn and so on. To understand this, I draw this diagram. Here the charge is Q1, here Q2 and Q3. If I need to find the potential of this system, then what is PE beta? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught remains common in these three. Then Q1, Q2, Q2, Q3, Q1, Q2, Q2, Q3. That is Q1, Q2 means force between these two. Q2, Q3 this means force between these two. And Q1, Q3 means force between these two. So that Q1, Q2 upon R12, Q2, Q3 upon R23 and Q3, Q1, QR 3, 1. Is it okay?